गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल एंड टुडे वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट प्लेसेस अराउंड मैसूर। दिस प्लेसेस आर रियली वंडरफुल फॉर वन डे ट्रिप्स अराउंड मैसूर। इफ यू वांट टू विजिट प्लेसेस विद इन मैसूर देन आई हैव सजेस्टेड 30 प्लस प्लेसेस इन माय लास्ट वीडियो। प्लीज क्लिक ऑन द आई कार्ड अबव सो दैट यू कैन पिक योर फेवरेट्स।
माय फर्स्ट रिकमेंडेशन इज हिमवत गोपाल स्वामी बेट्टा।
दिस प्लेस इज ओपन फ्रॉम 8:30 AM टू 4 PM इन द इवनिंग and it's about 78 kilometers from Mysore.
It is the highest peak in Bandipora National Park. Dense fog predominates and covers the hill round the year, hence it has got its name as Himavad.
Also, you have Venugopala Swami Temple here. This place is also frequented by the wild elephants. When you visit here, you will definitely spot wild elephant herds. Once you reach the base of the hill, there is a parking area, so you have to park your vehicle there and then you have to take government bus to reach the hilltop. This is one of the perfect spot. If you have come this far to Himavad Gopal Swami Betta, then I think you should also visit the sunflower farms around. These farms are just to the main road.
You can spend some time here and proceed to the Bandipora forest.
At Bandipora National Park, you can take a tiger safari to the forest. When it comes to wildlife sighting, this safari is always rewarding. Usually, this safari starts from morning around 6 AM. In between, they have a gap in the afternoon and it ends around 7 PM. So, you can pick the slot whichever is convenient for you and the type or the mode of safari also. You have that option as well. So right from the start to the end till here, you can cover this entire places within one day. So this is a perfect one day trip from Mysore that you can plan. My next recommendation is Shivana Samudra. So you have Barachukki and Gaganachukki Falls over here. And this place is around 78 kilometers from Mysore. And this is also a perfect one day picnic spot that you can plan from Mysore. Along with this, you can also plan for Mekedatu as well if you have time. So also you have lot of slots that is available like for the food and everything at this place. And it's better to visit this place in monsoon, so the water flow during the monsoon will be really great, and during the summer, like from December onwards, it will be usually dry. So I would recommend you visit from June to September is the best time to visit this place. If you really have very less time and you want to make a best use of it, then this is the perfect place for you, and it's really very scenic and it's a perfect spot for people who wants to bird watch. This is just around 15 kilometers from Mysore and you can easily reach within 45 minutes to this place. And if you're wondering what place is this, this is known as Bottom Lake. If you can see, this place is about 15 to 20 acres spread out area. And this is a really very beautiful place, and if you want more details on this place, please click on the iCard above. I have explained the complete route details and everything, how to reach this place, in that video, and I have also given the background of this place, so when can you plan and all. So it's always better to plan this place either in the morning or in the evening. So this is the perfect spot during the weekends for the Mysoreans. My next recommendation is Dirdaladmara. If you are wondering if it is the same one that is in Bangalore, no, you're wrong. This is the one very near to the Mysore. It just takes about 15 minutes drive from Mysore. This place is really beautiful, and this tree is also around 400 years old. Many movies have been shot here, like Raja Hindustani and recent Love Mocktail as well. If you wanna come here, I think the best time is in the morning or the evening. So many of them plan this place as a one-day picnic spot. So it has a dedicated parking space as well. So there is no entry or exit charges. If you are planning to go to some kind of a trekking near Mysore, then you have really a very beautiful Kuntibetta nearby. It's just about 30 kilometers from Mysore, I think. This place is also famous for night camping as well, and many people come here even during the early morning time, so they can witness the sunrise from this place. Very close to Kuntibetta, you also have Kere Tonnuru, that is a lake which is very near to the hill. So you can visit there. There are a lot of water activities that you can take place, like kayaking, boating, and many more. Complete details of this trek, route details, and the activities that you can plan for, everything I have described in the Kuntibetta vlog, so that I have linked in the iCard. Please have a look at it, so that will help you as well to plan your trip to Kuntibetta. Next place is Birota Watchtower and Ganalu Falls. This is again about 82 kilometers from Mysore. You can plan Birota Watchtower, Ganalu Falls, and make it that too as one day trip from Mysore. One must remember that if you are visiting Birota Watchtower, then you should have a permission from Forest Department to visit this place, because it's in the reserve forest area. The complete details of Birota Watchtower and Ganalu Falls I have added in my different video of this place, so you can click on the iCard above, and you can also check in the description for the link. This place is quite famous for its river valley. Everybody refer it to be as a Kaveri river valley, but it is Shimsa river. This is a tributary of Kaveri. Ganalu Falls is just about 6 km from Watchtower, so it is better to visit from June to November if you are planning to go here, because there will be no water in Ganalu Falls apart from the monsoon time. You also have a canal at the start of the Ganalu Falls, so you can also sit there and relax. There will be water all the time in the canal, so that is one more good spot. So my next recommendation is Srirangapatna. If you are going to Srirangapatna, there are a few recommended places that you must visit.
One is Srirangaswamy Temple and Nimishamba Temple.
So temple will be always open from morning 7 a.m. to 8:30 p.m. apart from the lunch hours, that is between 2 to 4. If you are a bird lover, then you must visit Ranganathittu Bird Sanctuary, which will be open from 8:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. You also have Darya Daulat Bagh, which will be open from 9 to 5, and Gumbaz from 8 to 6:30. Along with this, one more important place is Balmuri and Yedmuri Falls. This is also just 15 kilometers from Mysore, so you can visit over here as well. So my next recommendation is Sangama, where Kaveri and Arkavati river meets. So this also could be a one day picnic spot near Mysore. Next place you can visit is Melkote. If you are in Melkote, you have to visit two temples, that is Chaluva Narayana Swami and Yoga Narasimha. Next we have historical place like Somanathpura, which is just about 35 to 40 kilometers from Mysore. Also, within 80 kilometers from Mysore, we have Shravana Belagola, so you can visit here as well. Don't forget to take a guided tour when you visit these two places. There are really lot of places around Mysore, like Coor, Kannur, Wayanad, Ooty, Madikeri. So you can plan all these places as well. Mysore is a such place from Karnataka that is very near to all the beautiful places around. I have tried to list on few places that are quite famous, and hope you have liked this video. If you have liked it, please give it a thumbs up and do subscribe to my channel for more such videos.